answer rebutted anyway, so she'll be forced to make it happen, whether it be her or as I move up the chain of command. You know? And I want to be nice at it. I don't want to rip their heads off like my mom does. Mom shreds them to pieces. You know, that's just her personality, and she's laboring at being more peaceful. Those are just some of the things she needs to get out, and that just might be the way the path is going to be. You know, maybe they need their head shredded. Maybe there's things that she understands that we don't understand yet because she studies heavy. She's all into the history. She reads book after book after book, movie after movie after movie. She's all into that. She knows heavy stuff. She's been studying like the past since 2009, since we first started getting into it. You know, and she's able to discover things for herself. You know, she's beyond, you know, just, you know, getting information from Winston. She's actually taken Winston's advice and went and studied and seen the stuff and seen other pictures in other areas for herself and arrived at the conclusions that, oh yeah, what the thing that Winston really wants us to do is to start marching down to these offices when they give us these statute tickets and codes and stuff like that. Say, hey man, where's the bonds for the statutes? All right? Stuff like that. And then have to train the people, take the people into our hands and train them. And I was able to arrive to the idea with that information. I was like, oh, okay. They're going to be captive. All these people that have been screwing people over, we're going to take them captive and we're going to offer them this. You're either going to be our slaves and till our fields now and do the things that we say. This is my plan that I saw the big picture. And you're going to work for us and we're going to teach you the law of the land, admiralty law, until you proved yourself you could learn the system and you can work your way up like we did and get your own freedom. And once you do that and prove yourself, then you'll be free because there'll be nothing to hinder you. Or if you refuse to learn and be in captivity, then you're going to be taken out on a ship in the ocean and shown the plank, and we're going to whistle for the sharks, and that will be your own option. You'll either be in captivity learning this stuff, working for us, laboring, working for us, or we'll call it labor on our part since our merciful, or you could be offered the plank. All the way from the pirate attorneys to all their pirate handlers that they have working for them. That's the plan that I figured out how it's going to work, and it's going to be smooth, man. It's going to be smooth, and it's going to be with all the backing of all the military and all the good guys. Remember, in the military, in the corporations, even in the somewhat attorney firms, there are good, well-intending people, right? Not all the attorneys really know the thing that's going on. Some of them are kind of blind. However, for the most part, most of them know, and they're pirating, screwing everybody one over. My point is that in government, in all the corporations we have on Earth, and in the military, there are good people and there are pirates. The good people are just waiting for us, right, to march down to their offices face to face and deal with them and show them the maxims of the law and say, look, there's the maxims of the law. This is the real law that supersedes you. Where are the bonds that are backing up these codes and statutes that you're trying to enforce over us? And when they don't have the bonds, that's where the ultimatum is going to be shown to them. We're going to talk to their superiors, and their superiors are going to say, oh, we can't touch this. They're in your hands at your mercy, so we will take them under our wing as laboring servants, teach them the law while they serve us, and they will earn their freedom. And the ones that don't want to learn will be given the option to walk the plank. And as this starts to spread throughout the earth, military and everything will be enforcing this. See? This is how it's going to be. since I received this guitar, the man who brought this guitar to me, he delivered it to me for very little, because he had to make a car payment. He's having problems with his woman, and he was running off to another city. He said, "Screw her, I'm moving on." And I told him, I said, "Hey man, there's another way to make money." And I started explaining. He says, "Oh yeah, I know, I heard that, accepted for value stuff." I says, "Well, yeah, that's part of it. You have to put in the claim lien, brother, and then obtain those private bank accounts." So he moved on. So his spirit is in this guitar. Ever since I've received this guitar, my voice has just been, wow, let loose. Out in the backyard, I sing loud. I play the Winston seminars. Well, I've been playing the Winston seminars, but since this guitar, man, I've been singing loud and clearly. Everything's flowing out clearly out this voice from the Holy Spirit to the neighbors, right? And it's gonna spread, people. So when we start to see the big picture clearly, right? When we start to stand over everything and see it from the high mountaintop, when we oversee it, overstand over it and see it, not stand under it. Stand over it and see it. When we start to understand after, you know, months and months, years and years of study, you know, year upon year, two or three, six, 4 to 6 years, you know, that's my advice. I said, it's a 2 to 4 year, 6 year process. Some people it's 8, 10 to 20. It all depends on the person, you know, and how Elohim's will draws them in to the things of his purpose. It's his will be done, not ours. She just started talking right away. I learned this. She throws this in my face. She says, "Look at this." You know, she's like that. You know, "Look at this." I looked at it. She had highlighted the maximum law that said all statutes and codes must be bonded. And I saw that and I was like, because she received a letter from the city saying, "Oh, your grass is too high. You know, needs to be mowed." And it wasn't. They were lying. They're screwing me, right? So she went down to the city and she said, "Where's the statutes and the code? Where's the bond for the statutes and code you're pressing here?" And my dad, he's not into this commercial stuff. He's just old school. He's from the old school of, "Prove it. Where's your pictures?" He's just like that. I think my dad just kind of secretly understands some of this stuff. He just really doesn't want to deal with it. He didn't want to cause any waves and any trouble. However, his way of dealing with things is, "Prove it. Where's the evidence?" You know, that's his thing. That's just my dad. That's the way of life. That's the way he grew up back in the old days. Their thing was, anything went up against him, "Where's the proof? Prove it." So yeah, you know, and they never contacted him back. He said, "Prove it." They never called him back. However, my mom saw a door to enter in to get some things flowing here. She's like, "Oh, this is my ticket to get in there to cause things to happen." She went down there and she told me, man, the young man was down there. Friend, "Where's the bond?" And he was like, "Well, there's the attorney's office down there. Go talk to him." So eventually, my mom's gonna go talk to the attorneys. Now another.